Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at using filters in iMovie. So I'm using the latest version of iMovie 10.1, which has some new filters. So if you're not using the latest version, you won't see everything that I'm doing here. I'm going to go File, New Movie, just to create a blank, no theme movie. And I'll just use the default name here. And then I'm going to import some media. So I'm just going to drag and drop a video clip right into it here. And you see it adds it, the clip there, and it puts it in the timeline. So now I've got this video clip and I can see the preview over here. So with it selected, you notice I can deselect it and I can select it, and it's got the yellow outline. Now with it selected, I can add a filter to it. So in the preview area over here, you've got a lot of different buttons. The button over here that looks like three overlapping circles, that's the one where you can get to the filters. And then you've got clip filter and audio effect. You want to use the clip filter menu here, and it will bring up this display that you can move around, and it shows you all the different filters. And to preview each one, all you need to do is move your cursor over it. So for instance, it starts off with none, and you can see that the video is actually playing there on the right with my cursor over it, and you can actually see the orange line as it appears which part of the video it's playing. And it's just going to keep looping. Now if I were to move to a filter like Camo here, you can see it changes it. And you can go back and forth easily between the two of them to see the difference. And you could go to all these different filters, and basically what most of them are doing are changing the colors in there. So they're making it look different. So for instance, heat wave, everything is just more severe there. Camo versus none, you can see the difference there. More muted colors there. Some of them are a little different, like for instance flipped will actually flip the video, which you may need in certain circumstances for a visual effect. You also have things like black and white that just remove all the color, and then you have versions of those. So you've got black and white, but you also have noir, which makes it a little more severe, and then you've got some filters that make it look like old film, and the first one of those is silent era, which you can see the fades out the corners there in the edge, add some lines in there to make it look like old film. We've got some other ones like that, like for instance you go to vintage or aged film here, which keeps the color but adds those lines in there, or even film grain, which makes it look all grainy. So you have a lot of options if you want to make your video look like it's old video rather than something you just recorded. Now to apply one of these filters, let's go and pick one like, say, the vignette one here. I can just click it. So I was just rolling over before, now I've clicked it. Now it's selected, and you can see it actually says the name of the filter there. And this entire clip will now play with that effect. To get rid of it, I would select it again and then just go to none like that. Now what if you want a filter applied to only part of your clip? Say you have a long piece of video, you're not really adding more clips or editing it in any other way, you just want to filter it. Well, the way you would do that is you would split this one clip into multiple parts. So you can click anywhere in here to position the line, and then you can modify split clip or Command B. When you do that, Command B right there, now I've split it into three pieces, and I can apply a filter only to one of these. So as I move my cursor here and I see the preview at the upper right, I can see that there's no filter there, no filter there. And I could also apply a transition to that I'll click on transitions there, and I will just do a cross dissolve, and I can put a cross dissolve between these, and now what I get is I get a transition into a filter like that. So these are of course all preset, and there's really nothing you can do to modify them. However, you can do your own in a way. You can turn it off so I have no filter on it now, and I can use things like color adjustments to actually adjust the color to something I like, do all sorts of things to the video. So I basically just set my own color parameters there so that I kind of have my own filter on it. Now you can't do special effects like those lines in the aged film kind of thing, but you can at least do your own coloring with the colors here rather than using the preset filters.